Hello and welcome to today's Premier Challenge, where we will be presenting the top card of today's matches. I am Matthew Hui.
And I'm Jonathan Chiang.
And we will be commentating for this, the first of our broadcast today, which will be the top 8 match between Wilson Foong and Bryan Tan. Alright, so Wilson actually sneaking right into top card, beating the bubble.
Yes.
Like my friend over here,
yeah.
Who has not had much fun beating the bubble in recent tournaments.
Very familiar with bubbling out of top 8.
So Wilson sitting pretty in the 8th seat, and we'll be taking on Bryan Tan, who is unbeaten today up to this point. So all the pressure on Bryan Tan, because the nature of Singapore tournaments is that whoever wins in Swiss tends to not make it all the way to the end.
Yeah, we call it the Swiss curse. Yes.
We'll see if Bryan can break the Swiss curse today.
Yep.
Alright, so we will be going into the battle shortly.
Yes.
I believe Bryan has been running somewhat non-standard teams of late, but I believe today he has gone to the tried and tested Big Six. I'm not entirely sure actually.
Yeah. And Wilson is still using his double primals team, which he has quite a lot of success with.
Yeah, Wilson I think has won a Premier Challenge with
indeed.
Yeah. Exact team.
So we'll see whether Wilson can pull off his second feat of winning this Premier Challenge.
Right. And Bryan will be gunning for his first ever Premier Challenge win.
Yes. Okay, so both players are choosing their...
Not yet.
Yes.
Still getting ready. So as we setting up the stream, so I think we can talk a bit about our battles today. Where I suppose you didn't have the greatest of luck, but that's the game we play.
Lots of hacks today, but yeah, that's the nature of the game. Best of one especially. Very prone to hacks, but then again, I think I've learned something that I have to control my tendency to get hacks in this format. So something to learn today, so not that bad. Yeah.
Right, so anyway, my own travails today were a result of me relying too much on pressing the button known as Dark Void. So, a crush that I should know better than to rely on, and a crush that let me down today, but a crush is a crush. And now we will be looking at both players' teams.
Yes.
Wilson will be running with the dual primal, the Groudon, the Kangaskhan, Salamence, Amoongus, Kyogre, and Togekiss.
And Bryan will be running Dialga, Landorus, Talonflame, Kangaskhan,
Kyogre,
and Ferroton. And I think it would be a trick room team, and he's running both two steel types in his team today. We'll see whether Wilson's Groudon will have his way with his team, or whether Bryan has some kind of a strategy up his sleeve to counteract Wilson's double primals.
Right, the thing about Dialga is that even as a steel type, one thing it does lack is it lacks a fire resistance.
Yes.
So even with Kyogre on Bryan's side of the field, Groudon is still going to be able to press Precipice Blades quite happily.
Yep, and Ferroton would not want to stay in when Groudon is around because of the 4 times fire weakness.
And Ferroton has trouble hitting Groudon really, unless he has Leech Seed. And that's a very passive way to deal with Groudon.
Yeah.
So Bryan definitely having two options on his team, if the Dialga is indeed, as we expect it to be, a Trick Room Dialga.
Yes.
He has the Talonflame for Tailwind as well.
And Bryan should be careful about Wilson's Amoongus as well. And if he sets up Trick Room and does not check Wilson's Amoongus, the Amoongus can potentially spawn a lot of Pokemon in Bryan's team.
Yeah, Trick Room can definitely backfire on Bryan in this matchup. So I think we see that Bryan really only has one option for Mega here, whereas Wilson has the dual option. Yeah. And you would think Wilson wants to bring his mans into this matchup.
Okay, now we are going into a game. The players have shaked their hands, and let's see.
Alright, so Bryan against Wilson, and we will see the Kyogre Salamence come out from Wilson's side of the field.
Yep, and on Bryan's side of the field, we will see...
It is the Dialga and the Landorus.
Yes.
So, somewhat reminiscent of what Wolf was pulling off in a recent regional, though I'm not entirely sure whether Bryan does have access to the same Telepathy Dialga to enable for the explosion shenanigans. So even if X explosion after the Intimidate from Salamence, probably not the best play.
And Wilson leading with his Salamence and Kyogre, Salamence to get the Intimidate drop off Bryan Tan's team.
And of course, from our position here, looking at Wilson's side of the field, we can note that his Kyogre is the fast variant of Kyogre.
Yes.
With HP, no HP investment. So definitely the threat is a trick room here, because even if a double target, Wilson has no way to one hit kill the Dialga.
Yep.
Though Intimidate onto the Landorus is going to make it somewhat not entirely the best option here, because Landorus does not do much damage at all to either Salamence or Kyogre.
Yeah, especially after the Intimidate drop.
So maybe you would see a U-turn from the Landorus to get out right now?
Yeah, maybe. Not too sure if Bryan wants to set up Trick Room, especially with the Among Us in the back, which I think Wilson will be switching in this turn.
But at the same time, Dialga does threaten the Salamence, so
yes.
Wilson has to think twice about keeping his Salamence in, because yep. Well, he does keep the Salamence in, however.
Okay.
So, are we going to see an attack, or are we going to see the safe protect from yep. the Salamence to block the Dragon Pulse?
So.
Oh, we do see the attack from the Salamence. Hyper Voice coming out into the Landorus, which I think it's clear to us that it is not the Assault Vest Landorus
yes.
based on that damage. U-turn does come out, so perhaps a choice ban Landorus, though that was very little damage
yeah.
though.
Yeah, that's very little damage actually, quite surprising.
So perhaps not item lock Landorus, but I guess we shall see. And this is the Ferroton, I believe. Yep, Ferroton yes. does come out, as Kyogre will get a free Water Spout off. Even on two resisted Pokemon, a full health Water Spout going to do a lot of damage to the Dialga.
It's going to hit quite hard, as you can see there. Trick Room does come out. Wilson not sending in his Among Us this turn.
Now, Among Us is a very sweet switch in if he has it at the back.
Yes.
He's not really threatened by anything. Dialga, even if, I suppose, if Dialga has a fire attack, though, would you really want to press fire attack when Kyogre's on the field?
Yeah.
Even if you predict it to switch out?
Probably if I'm in Wilson's position, I might switch out the Salamence to Among Us. But we'll see what Wilson has to...
Wilson probably needs a solid check to the
yes.
Ferroton, because even if Among Us comes in, he can't really do anything.
Yeah.
But you would presume he has the Growlithe at the back.
Yes.
And so now would be the time to come in. Though he has to fear perhaps an Earth Power from
yes,
the
Yes, yes, especially because now Trick Room is up. Bryan could predict that Wilson is going to send in his Groudon and Earth Power that slot.
Though again, because we don't really know the fact, no switches coming out from Wilson. Are we going to see a double? Actually, it's not the double protect. So a Power Whip comes out from the Ferroton, and Dragon Pulse will go onto the Salamence. Can Salamence take a Dragon Pulse from the
No, I don't think so. This is it's a
Salamence
minus.
Does go down, so Wilson opting to sack his Salamence, I think.
I think it's a naive one as well.
Oh, yeah. That's true.
Yeah. So it's not going to survive that Dragon Pulse.
Here, okay. I would say Groudon has to come in, do you think?
Yeah, Groudon does come in. That's his Groudon. Yeah.
Yep, Jonathan,
now Bryan.
Now Bryan
is in an interesting position. Both his Pokemon quite threatened by the eruption or the P blades.
So you have to think that
since
Bryan is running a Trick Room team with slow Pokemon,
yes,
if Dialga and Ferroton were to double into Groudon, would that actually be enough to pick up a KO with it? Perhaps an Earth Power and Power Whip?
It might, because I think Wilson is running a very fast Groudon, so no HP investment. So if they double into the Groudon slot, it probably won't survive. So we'll see in this turn.
Yeah. But again, Wilson has very obvious protect as well if he sees that play coming. Right, so Dialga actually switches out, so Bryan not pushing his offensive pressure here, but actually opting to change the weather to rain to save his Ferroton from the Groudon's fire attack.
Yes. Quite a decent play.
And no switch from Wilson, so his Kyogre, already protected last turn, is going to be open to the Power Whip this turn.
Yeah, we'll see what Groudon will do. Probably a P-Blades.
Oh, we do see the switch come up, so Wilson does make the switch as well. So Kyogre retreating to the top of the Togekiss.
Into Togekiss,
who will take a Power Whip very comfortably.
Yep.
Power Whip does come out. Who does it target? It targets Togekiss. So a safe play from Bryan and a safe play from Wilson
well.
As well. Precipice Blades. Oh, misses the Ferroton, but does hit the Kyogre.
Okay.
So still a valuable amount of damage garnered. And Kyogre, clearly a bulky Trick Room version.
Yes, a very bulky one. You can see that it takes the P-Blades very, very well here. And Wilson will probably be doing the air slash another guns right now. Because I think his Togekiss isn't a very fast variant. So we'll see why he...
Alright, Togekiss, I believe, without speed. And if he... But again, if Bryan is running a quiet Kyogre, he might still underspeed Togekiss.
Jarabot,
so no follow me coming out. Gyarados comes out onto the Togekiss, should not pick up the KO, since as you said, it's not very fast. And yes, he does underspeed the Kyogre, and will flinch for the 60% flinch.
Will he get the flinch?
Nope, no flinch.
Not.
Water Spout comes out, will get two KOs.
Yes.
And Wilson...
Wilson not in a very good position here. He's left with one, I think. Yeah.
Yep. It's only the Kyogre left against Ferroton, and I believe with one more turn of Trick Room to go.
So very, very comfortable win for Bryan Tan right here.
And Bryan not really having to reveal that much information as well.
You can see that Bryan's dual primals and dual steel type team doing very well here. Especially against a fellow dual primal team like Wilson's.
Bryan is not running into a primal, actually. He has a Dialga.
Ah, yes.
Alright, so Kyogre going to protect. Wilson actually not forfeiting, opting to play this game out. Oh, he does protect.
He does
stall
protect
the last turn of Trick Room. Actually, No, oh, yeah, actually. Ferroton is not in the range to be killed by a water spout. Doesn't matter what you get. At full health with leftovers. But Wilson, hoping to clear out the rest of Bryan's field, at least kill the Kyogre perhaps.
Yep. Probably a water spout going to come out, but even then, don't think you will take down that Ferroton, you know, even with a critical.
Perhaps not even the Kyogre.
Yes, perhaps not even
Kyogre. He's taken some damage already.
It was still hit hard though.
Oh, the Thunder comes out. Should he have revealed the Thunder?
Yes.
Should he have revealed the Thunder at this point?
Yeah, that's the thing. Actually, if I'm in Wilson's position, it's better to forfeit, you know, to not reveal key moves like, you know, especially Thunder. Yeah.
Kyogre hangs on. So, well.
With two health.
Wilson will stall the game out a little longer as Landorus comes back in.
Yeah. And the Intimidate goes off to a special attacker. Not that it matters anyway.
Wilson perhaps hoping to fish out some information about Bryan's item, but no. Oh. Now he chooses to forfeit after revealing Thunder on his Kyogre. Yeah.
So very good game one on Bryan's end. Very solid 4-1. 3-1 actually on his side. Yeah. And now we'll be proceeding in game two. Yeah.
Wilson clearly has to adjust.
Yes, indeed. I think Wilson is very susceptible to Trick Room teams, especially because his double primals are running
fast mode.
Yeah, very fast. Yeah.
Yeah, we do see that both his primals are running max speed actually.
And his probably his check to Trick Room will be the Among Us and the Toggle Keys, which are negative speed, I believe. Yeah.
So he does have the out there though. Does his Toggle Keys run after you?
No, actually it runs follow me. Yeah. I don't think it runs protect as well.
I see.
Yes.
So I guess the other out would be to deny Trick Room with the air slash if he really feels lucky.
Yeah.
But he didn't get the roll earlier.
Yeah. So 60% chance of flinching is quite high, but the 40% is also very significant as well. And if you don't get the air slash pair of hacks, it can really decide a game.
Because the thing here, issue here is that Wilson probably needs to lead either of his disruptors to either deny or to get a better handle of the game under Trick Room. Because forced to make a lot of double switches and set things earlier in the first game.
Yeah. And that can be very punishing on Wilson's end, especially his team is not really invested into HP and it will take a lot of damage by all this switching in.
An interesting note would be that Bryan actually didn't bring his Mega in last game, the Kangas Gun.
Yeah, we didn't see any Mega at all.
And actually more importantly for Wilson, he would have noted that Bryan did not bring the Talent Flame. Talent Flame might be the one thing stopping him from bringing Among Us right now.
Indeed. I think he was afraid of the Talent Flame. But I think... Do you think Bryan will lead with the same thing? If I'm him, I'd probably lead with the same thing. But since I'm a very solid lead against Wilson.
Bryan really has very little reason. He can perhaps even drop the Landorus if he feels like it. So Landorus is clearly there to stop any potential Groudon lead from Wilson.
So I think Wilson, if he wants to claw back from a 1-0 loss, he has to prevent Trick Room from being set up or, you know, find a way to deal around with Trick Room.
I mean, the other problem for Wilson is that he doesn't know whether what outing the Dialga is carrying.
Yeah, indeed.
So he can't really lead Among Us hoping to spawn the Dialga. If it turns out to be Lum, it might be hard to recover from him again too. As we do see Kangaskhan and Kyogre coming out, so Wilson making the adjustment, bringing the Fake Outer to try and deny Trick Room on the third one.
So we'll see whether the Kangaskhans are inner focus.
Alright, they really come from Landorus to nerf Wilson's Kangaskhan by a little bit. Yeah. So Wilson does bring the Kyogre, which is going to put a lot of pressure onto the field since Bryan has no way to change the weather away from rain.
Yes. So we'll see whose Fake Out come out first and whether they even Mega Evolve.
It's somewhat a common bluff to know that you and your opponent are running in the focus, but in reality, it's not always the best play because normal Kangaskhan is very frail. So if you mispredict and stay in non-Mega form and your opponent Kangaskhan just go for a low kick, you're just going to go down.
Yes. So...
So Wilson, I believe, running a fast Kyogre. So if Bryan's Landorus is not running anything other than max speed, it's going to be slower than Kyogre here.
Yeah, so Bryan might be taking a very painful hit from Water Spout.
Though for all we know, the Landorus could be holding the Focus Sash.
Yeah. Not too sure if Bryan's Kangaskhan is minimum speed
as well. Yeah. Or if it's a bulky variant.
Yeah. But I would think it would be a bulky variant, especially he's running a full Trick Room team.
Yes. Well, he does have the Talent Flame, I suppose, for a fast mode.
Okay, both players taking their time to think through their moves.
Bryan, in this case. Wilson has already locked in his moves.
Yes.
So Wilson, with a somewhat straightforward fake out water spot play, I think. Though, yeah. I suppose there's a fake out mirror to worry about.
Yes.
Right, so okay. We do see Mega coming out from Wilson's side of the field. So
I think
we do know that Wilson is probably running the max speed Kangaskhan,
yes.
And Bryan probably not max speed. So yeah. Probably, yeah, we do see the fake out come out, and Bryan does call the bluff and stays in inner focus to get his own fake out off. Yep, we do see the inner focus fake out come out onto the Kyogre, and Landorus,
yes,
will get a free attack. You would think a U-turn, yep, for free damage into the Kyogre.
So what do you think Landorus will U-turn into? Probably Daga?
I believe we did see Kyogre flinch already, so
yeah.
Landorus is slower than the Kyogre. Hmm. Information for both players to note going into the rest of the games. Dialga here will be ideal because Landorus,
yes.
Kangaskhan is intimidated, so low kick is not going to be able to KO Dialga.
And Dialga would most probably be able
to. Oh, actually, no. Kyogre does move after Landorus.
Oh,
so
okay.
It's probably a jolly 252 speed Landorus there. Or even a Scarf, but.
Don't think so, yeah.
No, we did see the Salamence go before Landorus last game, so it's probably not the Scarf Landorus.
Yes, yes. And it's also not the Salt Vest variant, so wondering what Bryan has on that.
Could be banned as well because the damage isn't really.
Could it be Lumberry?
Yeah, it could
it
be
could Lumberry. Be yes.
All right, so Kyogre not able to do much right now, having been damaged. We'll switch. It's this time for Among Us to come in.
And he switched into
his
Among Us.
Yes, it is time for Among Us to come in. Wilson is calling the Trick Room this turn. So with the intimidated Kangaskhan, is he going to try and get a low kick KO on Bryan's Kangaskhan? Yeah, he does go for a low kick and minus one against a bulky Kangaskhan. No, it's not going to be enough. Bryan's bulk definitely coming through here. And if he goes for his own low kick, he goes for the double edge.
Into the Among Us.
Is that a Rocky Helmet?
No,
it's a Citrus Berry, so no recoil, no added recoil for Kangaskhan this turn. Though he might kill himself with the recoil from double edge itself.
Will that be
able?
Yes,
Kangaskhan does go down, though. Is that really a bad thing for Bryan? He gets to bring in a super for free right now.
Oh, and Trick Room does come out. So
and Wilson is still stuck with a minus one Kangaskhan.
Yeah. But Wilson is
maybe even minus two if Landorus comes in again.
But Wilson is actually in not a bad position because his Among Us can freely spawn, especially under this.
So again, you did speculate that the Landorus could be Lumberry.
Yeah.
You thought you would actually expect either of these things to be Lumberry.
Yes, actually. So we'll see whether Among Us does spawn. I think in Wilson's case, he will go for the spawn.
Yeah, there's very little reason to Rage Powder here.
Yeah.
Since Landorus is. Well, would you Earthquake? Well, if you have Telepathy Dialga, then now will be the time to Earthquake.
Yeah. But I think we'll see which of Bryan Tan's Pokemon carries the Lumberry.
Alright, so Kangaskhan, I think we'll have to switch here.
Yeah, with the minus two, Kangaskhan is probably not going to do anything at all.
And faster than. Oh, stays in. Spore goes onto the Landorus. Are we going to see the Lumberry? Landorus will go to sleep and. Nope, no Lumberry. Flamethrower.
Dialga
reviews Flamethrower onto the Among Us, which will pick up the KO.
Yes.
And Kangaskhan will get. Bit of damage onto whatever it chose to target this turn.
Yeah, but very interesting. What does what item does Bryan Tan runs on his Landorus? It's not Lumberry, it's not Choice Scarf.
So perhaps the focus set. Oh, he gets the critical hit with the low kick and does not bring down the Dialga. The minus 2 second hit of low kick, showing just how much damage it would really have done.
Yeah.
Barely 10% on the second hit.
And Dialga's bug really coming in through here. That lucky critical hit.
So maybe the Landorus will be holding the focus set or the life orb. Well, again, no, we haven't seen Life Orb recoil, so perhaps a Focus Sash.
Yeah.
Tiger comes in and in this position, Dialga in a pretty awkward position because Dialga probably cannot 1-hit KO either of these Pokemon. Unless we've seen Dragon Pulse, so probably no Draco Meteor.
And with Landorus Sleep, if it doesn't wake up from this turn of sleep,
we'll easily go down to any water attack.
Yes.
Right. Bryan looks like he's trying to wake up with Landorus. No Protect coming out. As Sucker Punch goes into the Dialga and... Kyogre!
Ice Beam,
under speeding. Oh yeah, yes, we call Landorus is faster than Kyogre. So are we going to see the Focus Sash? No, no Focus Sash. So Bryan's Landorus item still remaining a mystery.
Yeah, very interesting. But I think very good information for both players as well.
Perhaps it really is the choice ban, just that the damage isn't what we expect it to be. Since Lenoros still didn't try to protect that third.
And Bryan,
so Bryan brings his own Kyogre, still under Trick Room, so he will have the speed advantage. Though, minus two Kangaskhan can Sucker Punch Bryan's Kyogre to try and reduce Water Spout's damage.
Or he might want to just pick off that Dialga. But Kyogre is probably going to get off a very strong Water Spout here if it's left, you know, undamaged.
Yes. Should not be enough to kill Wilson's own Kyogre, who would be able to get a Thunder in return.
I think Bryan is not looking in a very good position.
Still has speed advantage.
Still has a big speed.
Minus 2 Kangaskhan, not that threatening, even with the Sucker Punch.
Unless he gets a very lucky critical hit again.
Protect coming out from Kyogre, and he does Sucker Punch into the Kyogre, hoping to reduce Water Spout's damage, but at minus 2, that's kind of what we expect to see.
The Water Spout is going to come out.
And will KO the Kangaskhan.
Yep.
But at the same time, it will allow Wilson to bring in what you think.
Oh, hey, no! He survived!
Hangs on with the Sucker Punch, which I don't think is what he wanted.
Yeah.
I think you would think he really wanted to bring in Garden there.
I would think so too as well.
Though I suppose, with Garden on the field, then his Thunder would become 50% accuracy.
Yeah. Interesting position.
He can Sucker Punch again. Does he go for the Dialga to finish it off? Yes, he does call Bryan's bluff this time. Dialga did have the protect option, but chose not to use it, and will be punished for it.
So very, very good finish.
Spot will come out again. Will finish off the Kangaskhan, should not take out Wilson's Kyogre. Even with a critical hit, probably not enough. Who will get the Thunder off and steal the game, along with what Wilson has at the back.
I think he stayed in to get the Thunder off successfully, because 100% under win. And, he survived. He got the paralyzed also.
That's actually a lot of damage from the Kyogre with the Thunder. But I didn't expect that much damage.
Yeah, but
Groudon does come out and we'll seal the game off against a paralyzed Kyogre outside of Trick Room with even a Fire Punch will do.
So Bryan here...
Or Eruption even, but I suppose, do you really want to reveal that much? Groudon could just protect and let Kyogre finish off.
Bryan should just forfeit this match.
Yes. We actually haven't seen Wilson use anything on his Groudon other than Precipice Blades, I think.
Yeah.
So we're not entirely sure what fire attack he carries.
And he's been very lucky with the P-Blades, not missing at all.
Yes. So Bryan does forfeit, though he probably could have gone with the last turn to see what Groudon went for.
Yeah, see, Wilson really making use of the information he gained in Game 1 to seal off this Game 2.
And again, not going for the spawn on Dialga. I think he really suspects that Dialga is holding the Lumberry. Since he hasn't, and now that we've seen Dialga go into the red, we know it's not carrying the Citrus Berry.
Yes. But we also know that Landorus is not carrying Lumberry, so if Wilson decides to spawn the Landorus, that's very good information for him.
Wilson now has, Bryan now has really considered, does he want to bring Landorus? Because Landorus really did last game was to get intimidated onto Kangaskhan.
Yeah. I think it's very
helped in a way, but he didn't really get rid of the problem itself.
Yeah, and with Kangaskhan staying in, even with a minus 2, and still doing quite well.
Yeah. Just getting cheap damage on everything.
Yes.
And the other thing that Bryan needs to realize is that Landorus really interferes with his Trick Room mode.
Indeed.
Because it's so fast. Both of Wilson's primals underspeed is Landorus and will move before it under Trick Room. So it's going to limit his usefulness a lot since we know it is not Focus Sash. Since any attack, any fire attack from Groudon and any attack from Kyogre will KO Landorus.
Yes.
So Bryan might want to change things up in the next game, but again, so Wilson made the adjustment what Bryan actually did as well, bringing his Kangaskhan over, I believe, the Ferroton.
Yeah, not too sure whether in this next game, both players will lead the same thing. I think Wilson's case, he will probably lead the same, since that it worked. Yeah.
So Wilson will think about what mecha he wants to bring. He surely had a lot better luck with Kangaskhan instead of Salamence.
But he bought in the Moongers last game, so Bryan might want to capitalize on that and bring in the Talent Flame.
Definitely can do a lot of work.
Yes.
In fact, looking at Wilson's team, he doesn't have a single Brickbird resist.
Yes, actually. And Talonflame can tailwind. It's probably a trick win team, in fact.
And if Wilson doesn't bring the Intimidate, then Talonflame will just get a neutral Brickbird off on everything on Wilson's team.
Yes, indeed.
Right, so we will go into the deciding game of this top 8 stack. As we really see the Kangaskhan and Kyogre come out from Wilson. So no change from the game 2. As we do see Kangaskhan Talonflame come out from Bryan.
Okay.
So no Intimidate from both sides. And Talonflame and Kangaskhan together threatening a KO on anything Wilson has, really.
Yep.
With the double target.
I think Bryan really realizing that Amoongus can you know, when left unchecked in trick room, can really do a lot of redirection, a lot of annoying stuff to prevent your trick room strategies from going up.
And I think we're not going to see any inner focus shenanigans this turn, since Wilson really does not want. He's really been burned by inner focus once, and secondly, now there's a threat of quick guard on the field as well.
Yes. He might just go for the low kick right off the bat.
Yeah, since he knows he's faster and has not been intimidated. Though, again, from game one, he would have noted that even unintimidated, he's not going to get a KO with low kick.
Yeah, especially with that very, very bulky ground Kangaskhan on Bryan Tan's field.
Though, if Wilson, a very fine cargo will definitely nerf any water spout. So, and do we know whether Wilson actually carries two water attacks?
Ah.
So if Wilson does have Origin Pulse, this will be the turn to use it.
So does Bryan want to keep his Talent Flame in this field? You know, especially with the water spout being a very big threat.
Are we going to see a Seaside Tailwind coming out from Talent Flame? Which will be a big change from Bryan's previous strategy of Trick Room. Alright, we do see both Kangaskhan's Mega evolve, so definitely no inner focus shenanigans. Though, again, Quick Guard is a possibility with Talent Flame.
Or is Wilson going to call that Quick Guard and fake out the Talent Flame?
Oh, we do see Bryan going for the fake out onto the Kyogre, I believe, yes.
Ah,
so,
okay.
Kyogre is going to have his health nerfed immediately, so Water Spout kind of taken off the table. And we do see Tailwind come off Talent Flame.
And Wilson probably going for the low kick.
Yeah, we don't see Loki come out. Is it going to be enough to KO?
I don't think so, unless it's a critical.
Yep, Kangaskhan will hang on.
Yep.
Though, not a terrible turn for Wilson here, because if Kangaskhan had gone down, Bryan would have been able to bring in a fresh sweeper.
Yes.
Under the Tailwind.
But now Bryan has the speed advantage with the Tailwind on his side.
Though, his Kangaskhan is kind of locked into Sucker Punch here. Because if he does Sucker Punch, then he will go down to Kangaskhan's own Wilson's own Sucker Punch.
Yep.
So a bit of a mind game there regarding Sucker Punches on both sides. And Kyogre will feel really threatened right now. Pinned down by both Kangaskhan and Talonflame.
And Talonflame, yes.
Rayford is probably not going to do enough, but definitely a double target here will bring down Kyogre. Though, Bryan will ignore Wilson's Kangaskhan at his own peril.
If I'm Bryan, I'll probably protect the Kyogre. And scout out what moves Wilson is trying to make in this turn.
And again, if Bryan predicts the Sucker Punch from Wilson, he can always, you know, Quick Guard to block the Sucker Punch. So if he predicts, let's say, a Kyogre Protect and a Wilson going for a Sucker Punch to Kangaskhan, a Quick Guard would easily stop that
I think
play.
That's a play that Bryan might go here. Quick Guard and then...
Though again, leaving Kyogre alone is always... Yeah, he does go for Quick Guard.
Quick Guard comes out.
So are we going to see a Protect? And we did not see a Protect from Kyogre. So this could go very badly for Bryan here. Kangaskhan is going to go for Low Kick into the Kangaskhan. It should KO. Wilson's fast Kangaskhan, but Kyogre is going to get an attack off in the rain.
And it's going to be very, very painful for Bryan Tan.
And we do see one smoke come out. Talonflame will go down, and Kangaskhan will be finished off as well. So Bryan down to his last two, but with the advantage of two more turns of Tailwind.
So in this turn, both players trading damage very well. But I think Wilson still has the slight advantage, even though Bryan has... Tailwind on his side.
Wilson realizing that Kyogre was the very obvious target and the Protect was even more obvious.
So very good call by Wilson right there. And now Bryan is down to his last two Pokemon. And we see the Among Us come out now with Talonflame out in the picture. Yeah, out of the picture. The Among Us is probably going to run a lot run rampant on Bryan Tan's team.
Yes, you would think that a combination of Ice Beam and attack from Landorus is not going to be enough to bring Among Us down. So I suppose Among Us does have the option here. Of course, Bryan, of course, he is under Tailwind, he has Landorus, he always has the one play he can make, which is Rock Slide.
Ah, we can see whether Rock Slide...
Rock Slide might be his only option to stop
when he gets the double flinch.
What he really needs is the flinch on Among Us, because Among Us is really threatening to spoil most of his team, and he can't switch anything out now, because he's down to his last two.
Yeah, even though he has Tailwind on his side. So I think... his target
does
probably,
go.
Oh,
so
does go for a
Bryan actually spending his own Trick Room turn. Are we going to see an explosion?
Tailwind turn actually.
Yeah, are we going to see an explosion come up from Bryan's Landorus actually? We do see the explosion, but Wilson does call it and protect his Kyogre.
Yeah, that is a very, very good play here, right?
So Landorus will trade itself for likely the Among Us.
Yes.
Does Among Us even go down? Among Us actually survives.
Very, very good play by Wilson, right?
So I think it's safe to say that is actually the choice band Landorus after all.
Yeah. But it took that very well.
Even Wilson, from a, I think, carrying a physically bulky among us, perhaps?
Yeah. Even from a plus one, Land of Us,
at this point,
probably.
Yeah. Wilson now can just rage powder and thunder for the win.
Yeah. And Water Spark,
Water Spark
goes
coming out.
It's not going to do enough.
Just bring down the Among Us.
And thunder is probably going to come out to. It won't finish off the Kyogre unless it's a critical.
Well, if he gets paralysis, that's just a cherry on top.
And knowing Wilson's luck, okay.
Dueller does beat out, but I think it's fair to say that Wilson does have the faster Kyogre, and Thunder will seed off this game. Even if it didn't, the Groudon is here. They will get the Precipice Blades off as well. In fact, now Thunder is not going to seed off the game, because it's now a 50% accurate move.
Yeah, so Wilson really taking the game 1 loss, the information he got from game 1 very well, and using it to his advantage, even though his team does not carry any form of speed control.
Yes.
Yeah.
That's right. We saw that how he actually discouraged Bryan from bringing Tailwind all in this game. He forced Bryan off his preferred strategy.
Indeed. And even with Tailwind on his
we
side,
do see the 50% Thunder avoid. And Ice Eagle go on to Groudon. And this could get iffy. If Precipice Blades misses here. In fact, it did, didn't it?
Yeah, actually.
Oh, Precipice Blades is going to land this time.
Okay.
And will steal the game for Wilson.
We'll move on
to the top 4.
Yeah.
Bryan with a sliver of a chance there. With both the Ice Precipice Blades and the Thunder missing.
But you can see this game, very strong win by Wilson, even though he lost the first game.
No, you would think Wilson probably should have been pressing in a fire attack there.
Yeah.
So who wants to interview Wilson?
Are we going to do interview or move on? Right, we're actually going to move on to the next round of games, since I think all the other players are done as well.
Yeah, so we'll see who is on stream next.
Definitely we saw that for all the speed control options that Bryan had on the table, Wilson just played his options correctly, made the correct switches, just controlled the momentum even when Bryan had all his speed control.
Yeah, indeed. Even though Bryan had an advantage in terms of speed in all three games, except for game one, Wilson really did make use of the kind of information that he gained in game 1 to leverage on that, and he took both game 2 and game 3 quite confidently.
Right, so I think it's... Alright. Justin Moss. Right, I think not actually... For me, the one moment in game 2 was when actually Bryan actually lost a Pokemon and was switching something in for the first time under Trick Room and chose to bring in his Landorus, which he knew at that point would be slower than Wilson's primals.
Yeah,
so
indeed.
In a way, he threw away his speed advantage that turn by going for another Intimidate onto Kangaskhan.
I think in game 3, Bryan probably sent out his Talonflame a bit too early, and it got killed, you know, before he can take care of that Amoongus, which is probably going to come out sometime later in the game. But yeah, that really cost him, you know, without that check to Amoongus.
Right, and we did see that he went for the so-called big play. He predicted the protect from Kyogre and the Sucker Punch from Kangaskhan.
And
went for the Quick Guard and got punished for it.
Yeah.
Right, so congratulations to Wilson, who will move on. And we will be showing the top 4 match subsequently between Harold Koo and Ronald Seed. Ronald actually defeating Melvin in top 8.
Oh, wow. Yeah.
And Harold overcoming the scrub known as Justin to move on to top 4 as well.
Okay, yeah. So...
Harrow actually running a very standard Rayogre team. And Ronald Seed, I believe he's very proud of the team he has brought today. Very proud of the gimmick he's got as well. Alright, so we'll be taking a break and we will be back with the top 4 game.
Interesting, today not a lot of pieces.